we have one kind of half of an episode that we shot completely on an iPhone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay. Is that coming up in season two?
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Awesome. See, I can understand that. Some of us guys who do this, we can understand that. Okay. So, tease what else is coming up in season two.
Well, we have everything from the latest trend among teenagers called fuck dancing to motorboating dads to the testicles that people are putting on their cars to a trip to China and Africa in one episode. And a lot of anachronistic opinions from Skip Reming.
Okay, so these stories, I mean, just what you've described and what I got to see in the clips, they're pretty wild. And yet the news itself is also pretty wild. Would you say that it's based on what you find in the news, or do you do things that are so wild that you're not even close
to
the news?
We look at how the news approaches things. So we'll, in the writer's room, we'll talk about, oh, well, 2020 would do one of these trend stories about what teens are doing. And then we'll find something so absurd, but that's almost believable. The goal is kind of, if people are flipping around or they don't know the show, they wouldn't at first know that it looks like a news magazine. But if they paid attention, hopefully they would figure out that it's not actual news. But you never know.
That's true. Yeah. I mean, you know, you have ghosts in Roswell. And
yes,
for a minute there, I was almost falling for it.
But that's right. That's like something 2020 would do now. That's how absurd the news is. That would really happen. They would do a story on, are there really ghosts in Roswell, New Mexico? And so we, of course, twisted that. I'm sorry. They would do a story on, are there really aliens in Roswell, New Mexico? So we twisted that with ghosts.
And you guys are going into your second season. Talk about a little bit about how your creative process works differently, maybe from season one to season two.
Well, that's a good question. Season one was quite a bit about, even though this is a spinoff of Children's Hospital, we had to create a completely new show because the Children's Hospital episodes were just about Children's Hospital. So season one was a lot of figuring out what the show is, what it isn't, who these characters are. Season two, we knew what worked and what didn't, so we could kind of just run with that and create the most absurd stories we could think of.
And also, you have a new host. I'm very excited. I am a huge brown coat Firefly fan. So I was very excited when I found out about that. So talk about Alan Tudyk becoming a part of the show.
We just feel so lucky to have. He was a big fan of the first season, and when we made the offer, he jumped at the chance, which was flattering and thrilling, and he just didn't miss a beat. He's amazing as Reagan Biscayne. He does stories on everything from what happens to people who lose on game shows to what the story that we tried to show you was him doing a story on a lottery winner determined to prove that it's a terrible thing, and the guy's just happy, and it drives him crazy. He has a lot of great stories, and he's such a great presence in the studio.
Fantastic. Okay, so if somebody has never seen Children's Hospital, they've never seen the first season, what would you say to them to get them to watch the show? What would be like your elevator pitch?
David Hasselhoff in three episodes.
Perfect. Thank you.